Hello there, Lamb fans. Right, video as promised. How I do the laser effects that I've been doing in the streams lately. If you don't know what I'm talking about, this is what I'm talking about. So to do that, I'm using this. This is a just a pretty standard run-of-the-mill office sort of type projector. This one is a an Optoma brand. I'm not quite sure of the model. I can't remember. But there's nothing particularly fancy about it. It is a DLP. It's not an LED projector. And it is full HD. So it's not too bad. It's got a few other ports and things like that. It's HDMI. Power down the bottom. So this is what does the effects. Now, what I'll do is I'll stick it back over here. I'll plug it in, and I'll show you how to set it up. So if you can see, I've turned it on. I faced it pointing at the wall, just so you can see it operating normally. It's very close to the wall, so the picture's not very big, but it's just got the Lamb website up there, let you see. And we've got the controls on the top to focus it, you know, like that, and then you can make it sharper or blurrier. There you go, it's a bit bigger, like, bring it into focus. So that's standard projector stuff. Now, to do the fancy effects, you need to download a piece of software, and that software is called MusicBeam. So let me show you how to do that next. So here's the website for the software. It's musicbeam.org, and this software's been around for a few years now. It's open source, it's free, so it's very good in that respect. So all you need to do is download it. And it'll download as a program there. You're probably going to want to use the Windows 64 version if you're using Windows. There's a Mac one, there's a Linux version. So there's a lot of options, but I'm going to use the Windows one. You just download the zip file, put the zip file into a folder, and run the whatever's in the zip file, basically. Just downloading it. It's going to open up now. There we go. So take all of that. Put it in a folder, and you see there's the MusicBeam executable. So what you want to do is run MusicBeam. Let's do that now. Okay, so this is the MusicBeam software actually running. And what I've got is I've captured the display that MusicBeam outputs, and I've got the interface for MusicBeam up there as well, so you can sort of see what's going on. Basically, I mean, the easiest way to figure out how this software works is to play with it. But there's 8 or so basic effects. So this is the scanner effect. There's a moonflare effect. RGB spots, Derby, snowstorm. I love the snowstorm. It's a good one. Laser burst. It also, if you see this graph up here, is listening to the audio coming out of the system. So it will do a beat detection thing. It's not great, but it does kind of work. So it'll try and send out these little laser pulses on a kick drum or something like that. And you can edit a lot of these settings. So if I click edit next to the snowstorm, I can choose the size of the snow blobs, if you will, or make a lot more smaller blobs. I can control the speed. I can turn it into color. That A there means it'll automatically change the color, or I can just set a color and it'll stay on that. And if we look at other effects, I've got similar sort of settings. There's weight, speed, the number of points, that sort of thing. What is nice about the software is when these lines blend together, the colors actually mix sort of as they would if it was a lazy. So they go sort of purple with a red and blue mix, and they go cyan with a green and blue mix and all of that. So play around with it is basically the idea. So this is what you want output to your projector. Now, if you're like me and you've got two monitors and a projector, you can come into a problem where MusicBeam is showing the graphics on the wrong display. So it's showing it on a monitor rather than your projector. So as a quick top tip, to get things to change between displays is a Windows shortcut key. So if you press the Windows key, Shift key, and the right arrow key, things will jump around to various windows, to various displays, sorry. So in this case, the scanner effect is showing up on my second monitor. So I need to select the window, the stage window as it's called, that shows the effect. If I press my Windows key and my Shift key and press right to move it onto the next display over. There you go. So you can see now it's coming out of the projector. rather than the display. So once, if you got to this stage, like me, you should have the control settings on the screen in front of you. Your projector should be doing something like this. One other thing you need to do is turn off the Windows taskbar. Otherwise, you have a white line all the time, and that looks bad as well. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to go to taskbar settings. Turn off show taskbar on all displays. Now you can see it's gone. So we're just getting the output from the scanner effect at the moment. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to turn the projector around. I'm going to point it directly at the camera. You want, essentially, the output from this to be in focus right on the camera lens. So sometimes what I do is I put a piece of paper up in front of the camera. That way you can get your projector aligned correctly and focused correctly. And then when you remove the piece of paper, you're shooting it straight down the camera. So let's do that next. Okay, so now it's running. I've turned it around. It's pointing directly at the camera lens. It's focused on the camera lens. It's quite important to check that. Focus. Yep, that's focused on the camera. So that's all good. It helps. This sort of distance is pretty good. Obviously, you want to sort of get quite a wide angle around the camera. And every now and again, you're going to see a flash. That's because it's actually still doing the scanning thing. And sometimes it hits the camera dead on, and that's when you see a very bright flash of light. Now, there's no smoke in the room, and this is the other crucial part of the equation. The laser beams, as they were, that are coming out of that, you're not going to see them because there's nothing for them to illuminate in the air. So you've got to have some sort of haze machine, smoke machine. So I've got one here, as you know. It's running through its little scanner thing. So as I hit the smoke machine now, you'll see that makes all the difference. So let's have a bit of smoke. And there we go. So obviously the projector is now able to illuminate the smoke in the room. And that's where you're getting the sort of the cool effects from. And if I step through some of the effect options now, you can see there's that moonflower one. There's a Derby one, that's the one with all the dots that moved up and down. There's the snowstorm that I like so much. Again, I think if you turn it white, it looks great, doesn't it? I love that. You can make the dots very small, you can move the speed down, you can speed it up, you can have it go crazy fast, you can have bigger beams. So there's a lot to play with, but the crucial elements are, you've got to have something for the projector to illuminate, and that is the smoke. So with those things, if you've got a smoke machine and you've got a projector, I don't know how it'll work with LED projectors. They're in the cheaper end of the market. They're probably just not as bright. Obviously, the brighter, the better, because the more striking the effect is then. That's basically it. So the software is MusicBeam, which you can download at musicbeam.org. The smoke machine I'm using, there's a video on that. I'll put a card up. Put a card up there if you want to see the review of this smoke machine. Cheap on Amazon, about £30. And it's worth buying some liquid to put in it as well. Projector, obviously, is quite an expensive unit. I think this one's around the £500 mark. Different ones, your mileage may vary, as they say. But that's it. Music beam, projector, laser effects, and a bit of smoke. Peace. Lamb out.